Unfreaking Believable by Paul Ieson. The story can be found inside the novel Swamp Dust. You can get this novel on Amazon. We live just outside of the swamp in our house with a few acres on it. In the back of our property, there's thick woods just before it turns into the swamp. In the summer, the kids go back there and they play. They have a tire swing to play on and plenty of space to explore and use their imaginations. If we, meaning the wife and myself, tried to keep them out of there, I think it would end up just being an unending battle that we would end up losing. This day started out to be no different than any other day. I was out in my shed working on a wood project for the wife, and the kids are out in the back doing whatever. My project was a haul tray for the mudroom, so I was really into it, not paying attention to the children and what they are doing. I hear a screech that is so loud that I can hear it, that I can hear the sound over my bandsaw that I am using. Then I hear a cracking and the sound of trees falling. Immediately I shut off the saw and run out of the shed. What the hell is going on? I don't think anyone paid attention to me, so I ran over to where the downed trees are, and the kids are all yelling. When I do reach the kids, I ask my oldest boy what is going on. This is where it gets weird. I know you are not going to believe me, but I think we spooked a dragon and it knocked the trees down as it flew off. I just look at him funny. Is anybody hurt? I ask. The other kids shout out, "Yes, Becky is. Come here so we can show you. She says she can't move." I move through the fallen tree branches as fast as I can get over there to see what is going on with Becky. "Dad, it hurts, and I can't move." She's trying not to cry. "Try and stay calm, sweetie. Let me see what I can do." "Someone go get the phone out of my shed and call 911. There is a branch from the tree going all the way through Becky's side and stuck into the ground. The limb is still attached to the big part of the fallen tree next to her. "Damn it, I don't have an extension cord long enough to reach out here. Will one of you boys please go to the shed and grab me my handsaw?" "Yes, Dad," and my two oldest boys then leave to go grab it. About this time, the dragon returns to the scene. He lands in the grass before where the tree line starts, and he walks up. When he gets close enough, he speaks. "My deepest apologies. I did not realize there were children playing when I tried to fly off. I am sorry my tail hit the trees. Please allow me to help." The dragon then walks over to where my Becky is, tossing brush and trees alike aside on his way over to the child. "Are you going to eat me?" Becky asks the dragon with a scared look on her face. "No, no, dear. I want to help you. This is my doing and I need to fix it." Becky smiles, then cries out in pain some more. The rest of us are just standing there in awe of what is going on. And even though the boys came back with my cell phone, no one thought to take a picture. We are all acting like deer in headlights. "I am sorry, my child. This is going to hurt a bit." The dragon takes his toenails and then cuts the branch from the tree. Becky screams out in pain. "Dear child, I am going to have to pull this out of your side. It will hurt quite a bit, but I will try and take your pain as I do this. May I continue?" "If you do it fast, then yes." Becky closes her eyes with anticipation of what is about to happen. "Wait." I order one of the kids to put a branch in between Becky's teeth so that she can have something to bite down on. "Okay, here we go." The dragon did not count. The dragon did not count. He just pinched the limb between his toes and pulled the branch out, and it started bleeding profusely. "Okay, I am now going to heal her side and stop the bleeding as well." The dragon lightly laid his foot on Becky's side. There was a glow for a few minutes and then she was healed. Everyone was still watching in silence of the events taking place. "How do you feel, young one?"
"Fine, thank you, sir."
She then hugs the dragon's leg and runs over to me. "Daddy, I'm fine. Look, there's not even a scar." I give her a big hug and tell her that I love her, and then give my attention to the dragon. "Thank you, sir, for helping my daughter."
What do I call you anyway?
Friend. Just call me friend.
He then walked back into the yard and flew away. All of us told my wife when she got home from work what had happened. Needless to say, she does not believe a single word of it.